Hey guys, welcome back. It's M.
B. Seven.
This is Key here.
And this is Rush the Yardie, aka Blondie Dread, alongside Burgundy Dread. You say, you see me? Wagwan, our good people, being in the building one more time.
Most definitely. Alright guys, we're getting to Fire Force, episode 7. I know we left off with episode 6, but you saw from our faces we was actually disappointed.
Upset. Very upset. Ahmad, you see me? I didn't like it.
I didn't like it either. No. I felt like the whole fight between Chara and Shinra
was a waste of watch. A waste of actually sitting down and spending 30 minutes of seeing them duking it out, and he still won. And she left.
Like, I'm disappointed in Inka's decision and her killing her friend
Panda. It's like, come on, man.
I'm like, didn't you just see your other friend get killed by Chara with one hit?
But in all fairness, though, she got to live her life, and that's the life that she chose to live. So, can't be mad and upset at the way she lived her life.
Getting disappointed for not being able to help her. So.
But Shinra, you need to get stronger. You need training, bro. Seriously. Company 8, you're lacking, bro.
So, right now, what we're going to see from episode 7 is that a special team is going over to China.
Mm-hmm.
To figure out what actually happened 250 years ago during the Great Cataclysm.
Yes.
That they're trying to figure out what the evangelist is trying to do.
And try to prevent
it from happening. And see if there's any other, Adolobus pillars that will be actually born over there too as well.
Yeah, because they need more people on your team. They need more Adolobus to fight against, what's they call himself?
The evangelist.
Yeah. Seriously, man,
Evangelist got 3-1, so.
Yeah, it was just upsetting, man, especially that fight, man. Even Arthur tried to go dumb, and he didn't even go dumb that much. I wanted him to go even dumb and just kick her butt, because they kind of have the same power, you understand?
Well, she has electricity, he has plasma, fire.
Yeah. Anyhow, he should have whooped that butt, though. On to the next one, yeah.
All right.
Jump to 7.
Yeah, you're from there, so you know.
You could have at least painted that shit.
Oh god. First step for man. Idiots! Someone said, no.
I write my name in there, that's right.
No, I was here. Mom?
Mm-hmm.
I need to see Dad. Maybe Dad is the
big one.
Show wins. You sure about that? Because I'm a country accent.
Oh, that's a car?
Sorry, you got so big!
It's a giant.
Whoa! gone, and how is he still driving? He gotta take over for these guys. No, it's not 2 minutes ago. Look at
this. He's slumped. When I say slumped, he's yeah. It's like I still got this.
Yo, he downtown now.
He's slumped. I'm getting even more slumped.
Help me.
Bandits.
But somebody just said help me.
I know.
Are you kidding me? Am I tripping on gas? I'm done with him. That's true. I would ask the same thing if I was in this situation.
Say if I'm tripping on gas.
Talking no? I'm mo? I'm talking mo?
No, is it a mo?
Yes.
Yeah. Hey, get off my car, bro. That's right, push him off. Push him off.
Yes, he's talking mo. Yo,
don't throw him, you might need him.
It's a potato. Those are my potatoes.
So you're the one stealing my potatoes, huh? That's right.
He about to squeeze it.
Liar. Liar.
I'm sorry, they all have.
That's what they call a squeeze of life. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah,
I'm
from
6 feet.
He
used
sword and
spear. Oh, giant
territory.
No, you're ready to fight?
I'm surprised you're not freaking about this mole talking.
That's alright. Life. It's a life we live.
Mask and go back to the original, you know.
Quirky
self. Shiva said, face me. Stop your turn.
He's still wearing his mask. Everybody has his mask. Surprisingly, it's not flaming up because they had fire all around them. Because he's a captain, the rest of them is not a captain. You know, only captain wear masks.
That's a lot of them.
Yes, they are a lot of them.
You can't put them in the rest.
The big giant that can destroy everybody up there. Yes! Bite him on the butt.
Oh, they scared us. when her clothes gonna come off.
I thought so too, but they haven't come off yet all episode.
Voice of the forest.
Mm-hmm.
She coming back to him?
Probably somebody else. Doesn't look like her or Flame.
It's a voice.
Yes,
it's
it
speaking
is.
To him. It was funny. It was funny. It was enjoyable. We didn't get down to the nitty gritty until we met the mole.
We got to know
and the crow.
And the hellhounds.
They thought there was infernal dogs, but they were like, they called.
I thought they would have been able to talk too, just like the birds.
But they didn't.
Maybe they can, and we just don't know yet.
They said that their boss is even worse. That one was crying for his friends that were killed.
R.I.P. dogs. Philippine. You see me? I cry for you to drop a tear.
So yeah.
To me, it was short. I was missing I wanted more action. I wanted to see what is coming up. You get me? I want to see a little bit more fight. You get me? Or something, because this episode was just them, just I guess on their road trip, on their way to the destination where they're going. But they did find a pillar or something there, you know. And I thought the mole was going to be a dollar burst, but the mole is not.
Yeah.
It's kind of cool though, a talking mole and a talking
crow.
They should add it to the team and bring them too.
If they want to, maybe they don't want to leave the oasis.
Maybe not. But the mole is by himself. The mole needs somebody. So make a friend mole. You see me? So we all can be friends.
Maybe we'll find out who that voice is that spoke to Shimra.
Yeah, it was like maybe she's a new spirit or something like that, or something like that. Yeah.
Maybe so. And then also. When we talk about the tabernacle, there was also what's there in the city in Tokyo,
mm-hmm.
where they came from. So they try to figure out was the one that there was the first one or this one, but that one looked like it's the first one.
Yeah.
Because how old it is and everything, and there's pillars around it. So yeah, that's all I have to say about this episode.
Well, as I said, this episode was a little bit too short. We needed more action. Content was alright, you know, it was a positive content, you get me? We understand where they're going, what where they're trying to get to, and a little bit of the backstory, you understand? And also we get to meet Juggernaut's mother and father, which was cool, you know, mom, pa, you get me?
His southern farmer accent.
Yeah, making potatoes, you know, you make them mashed potatoes, you know, some fire potatoes.
They own a potato farm, so...
And the mole is over there stealing. He's stealing.
He's hungry.
Yeah, you understand, you know, but you don't have to steal it because you want to ask for a potato, because I guarantee you people.
They probably would have gave Papa
Mom
probably gave
it to him. And then again, but maybe nobody has seen a talking mole, so they're probably not trying to beat him or kill him or trying
that
to
too.
Do something to him, but that's different, you know. But you don't have to steal, man. You can go and ask, you know. It's better things out there than to steal, bro. Don't steal. Bad mole.
Alright guys, so we're gonna end this video here. Thanks for watching.
Most definitely,
and
please.
If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you like the content that we put on this channel, please subscribe down below.
Definitely, and please hit that notification bell so you can stay up to date with our latest and greatest videos and content, guys. Because we do tend to put out a lot of content every single week, and we want you all to stay up to date with it. You get me, guys? Because we're friends, isn't me? Isn't me? Like, we're the mole with us. We are friends.
Most definitely, please remember to tell a friend.
To make a friend.
To keep a friend.
So we all
can be friends.
Yezimi. Big up to my partner right here, Key. Big up to myself, Blondie Dread. Yezimi, big up to my sevens. What's in mine? Big up to our sevens. Big up to all of our viewers and all of our subscribers out there, guys. Please stay safe. Please greet your loved ones. Talk to your loved ones again, because we're still in a little epidemic. And guys, please. Stay safe out there and think four times before you make that one stupid decision, guys. You see me?
Definitely. definitely. And we see you guys in the next one.
Peace and love. Blondie Dread out.